Right now, the state of Missouri is a fantastic place to do business. There is absolutely no question. We've got low taxes, low energy costs. We've got a great quality of life. We have an amazing research community. We have fantastic hospitals. We have fantastic universities. One thing that we have not been able to do is take a lot of the research that we're doing and commercialize it and turn it into an economic development opportunity. And we've seen other states, Kansas being one of them, and I see them most closely because I'm right there on the state line, who have taken those opportunities and really turned it into economic drivers for the state. And so MOSIRA is a tool that we can use to help commercialize some of the great research that's happening in our state. And I'm not going to spend a whole lot of time explaining the mechanics of this because we've got some great witnesses here today that I'd like to come up and explain it in greater detail. But essentially, all we are doing is we are taking and creating a new fund. There will be no new taxes. We are going to decide next year what the baseline is for companies in this area and the amount of payroll that they have, their gross wages. We're going to take a very small percentage of their future growth and put it into a fund so that we can start leveraging the fantastic research that already takes place in this state. It's an idea that has been talked about for years, frankly, especially after we saw Kansas and their Biosciences Authority Act and the extreme, it's just been a fantastic tool for that state. And so I'm excited that we have a really great, diverse group of folks here today who want to talk about it.
Today, in today's economy, everybody talks about creating jobs. We have the assets here to create these jobs and to grow companies, but we're not doing it. We're not leveraging it to the extent that we could. I'd encourage you to not underestimate the role that you as state legislators could play in this. You could make a statement today and in this session to pass MOSIRA, leading to the creation of a high-tech environment in Missouri and put Missouri on the map. And those results would probably manifest themselves within the next couple of years, certainly in the first 5 or 6 years. Missouri and Kansas together could become the center for biosciences in the country. That's not outside the realm of possibility.
Certainly, we have here in the state of Missouri a tremendous amount of strengths and assets in key technological fields. And as all of us know, particularly the plant science, animal health, and bioscience arena. In fact, the December issue of Forbes magazine highlighted Missouri in a 16-page spread in terms of our agricultural technology and history that we have and how it has led to the next generation of high-tech companies in terms of animal health and plant sciences. Certainly, we know that the St. Louis metro area is the home to more plant scientists than any other location in the world. We also are all aware of the animal health plant or the animal health corridor. It's the world-renowned animal health corridor that runs from Columbia through Kansas City up through St. Joe. And in fact, more than one-third of the world's $19 billion animal health and nutrition market is in that corridor. One-third of the global $19 billion industry resides in that corridor. So we have some real strengths. Certainly, Missouri, as the Senator indicates, ranks among the top states in doing competitive funded research. We have incredible scientists and scientific assets at both our public as well as our private institutions, but we need to accelerate their ability to grow new companies. We do know that there's room for improvement. Unfortunately, the Kauffman Foundation, which is the world's largest policy organization dedicated to entrepreneurship, has consistently ranked Missouri near the bottom of the 50 states for entrepreneurial activity. So there is certainly room for improvement. As again, as indicated from the previous speaker, we did in fact have been engaged for the last 7 months in terms of engaging more than 500 business, labor, economic development, and higher ed leaders from across the state to develop a 5-year strategic plan. We have identified 8 strategic initiatives, and as previously indicated, the need to invest in high-tech innovation entrepreneurship is one of those 8 strategies.